In designing or using any instrument, some fundamental decisions must be made. Is just the presence or absence of the variable all we need to know? Does a single number give sufficient information? Or is it necessary to know the instantaneous value of the signal as a function of time? Making any measurement may disturb the system. Part of instrument design is making disturbance negligible. We are going to look at electromechanical mechanisms used in instruments. The mechanism used most often is the permanent magnet moving coil, or the PMMC. It is based on the principle that a force is exerted on a current-carrying conductor in a magnetic field. The force is I cross B. The amount of deflection increases as the current increases. If the direction of the current is reversed, the conductor deflects in the opposite direction. If the current is changed abruptly, the conductor vibrates. This vibration is one of the characteristics that must be controlled in an instrument. In a permanent magnet moving coil instrument, the single copper conductor is replaced by a coil of many turns, which rotates between the pole pieces of a permanent magnet. By placing many conductors in the magnetic field, we can get a much more sensitive mechanism. Pivoting the coil transforms the motion from translation to rotation. The magnetic field surrounding the movable coil is controlled by the shape of the magnet and the cylindrical core. The way the moving coil is supported and restrained also affects the performance. Fiber, taut band, and jewel bearings are common supports. The magnetic field and the restraining mechanism are usually designed so that the deflection of the pointer is directly proportional to the coil current. Four equally spaced marks have been placed over the scale. This is the deflection across three series connected matched batteries. Two batteries, one battery, none. This meter comes pretty close to having linear deflection. Recall this response when the current was abruptly changed. In an instrument, this vibration is reduced by damping the coil mechanism. Eddy currents are produced in this aluminum disc by induced voltage. These currents are proportional to the velocity of the disc through the magnetic field and react with the field to oppose the motion, which is thus damped. PMMC mechanisms are damped by winding the coil on a lightweight aluminum frame. As the frame moves through the magnetic field, motion is damped by the eddy currents produced in the frame. We have two instruments. This one has been constructed by winding the coil without a frame. The coil in this one is wound on a conducting frame. Both instruments will be excited by a DC signal. Of the coil can usually be described by this linear second order differential equation. The torque exerted on the coil by the coil current must be balanced by the torque required to accelerate the mass of the moving parts, plus the damping torque, which is proportional to the angular velocity of the coil, plus the restraining torque, which is proportional to the displacement of the coil. Further insight into the behavior of a PMMC instrument can be obtained by observing its response to signals of various waveforms. In this PMMC mechanism, the permanent magnet lies inside the coil. The outer cylinder controls the magnetic field. This zero center ammeter closely follows low frequency variations in the coil current. This is 1 hertz. The needle deflects in both the positive and negative directions, since the PMMC mechanism is sensitive to polarity. When the amplitude of the low frequency signal is increased, the deflection also increases. The PMMC mechanism yields useful information about the instantaneous values of a very low frequency time-varying signal. A 1 hertz ramp. A 1 hertz square wave. The PMMC instrument cannot follow a rapidly changing signal. As I increase the frequency from 1 to 10 hertz, the amplitude of the deflection first increases slightly at resonance and then becomes smaller and smaller. I am not changing the amplitude of the driving signal, just its frequency. The smaller deflection is a consequence of the inertia and the damping in the mechanism. With the frequency higher, from 10 to 100 hertz, the amplitude of the deflection is zero. This suggests that the average deflection of the PMMC mechanism is proportional to the average value of the coil current. As further evidence of this, I will give the time-varying signal a non-zero average value by connecting a battery in series. At 1 hertz, the coil mechanism varies about the non-zero average value. At 100 Hz, the PMMC mechanism remains at the non-zero average value. At higher frequencies, the deflection is proportional to the average value regardless of waveform. These responses are in agreement with the differential equation we are using to model the PMMC mechanism. For example, when the coil current varies sinusoidally with time, the differential equation predicts that the steady state angular displacement also varies sinusoidally with time. As the frequency increases, the solution shows that the amplitude of the steady-state angular displacement first increases at resonance and then decreases. When the coil current is a constant plus a sinusoidal component, the steady state displacement is a constant plus a sinusoidal component. As the frequency increases, the angular displacement is proportional to the average current. We have seen that the displacement of the coil depends on the coil current, average current.